Near the very start of the Bible, in the book of Genesis, we find this story about Abraham and Sarah, a grandma and a grandpa. God tells them that they would have a baby. Most grandparents don't have babies, but as we're about to find out, when God makes a promise, he delivers. God had spoken to Abraham when he was 75 years old and said, "Leave your country, your family, and your father's home for a land that I will show you. I'll make you a great nation and bless you." God takes Abraham outside and says, "Look up at the sky and count the stars, if indeed you can count them." Then he said to him, "So shall your offspring be." But Abraham and Sarah did not have children. How was God going to make their family into a great nation without a single child? It was a promise that seemed so outrageous, so beyond belief, that Abraham and his wife Sarah thought God must have been joking. But Abraham was a man of faith, and so he did just what God had told him. He had to have faith in God. Abraham and Sarah waited and waited and waited. Years passed by, and they didn't seem to be any closer to what God had promised them. With faith in God, they waited. They both went through a lot while this promise waited to be fulfilled, made some bad choices that hurt others, made good choices that helped others. But through it all, they trusted the promise of God. Sarah was now 90 years old, and Abraham was 100 years old. God spoke to Abraham and said, "I will bless Sarah. She will have a baby son, and you will call him Isaac." "Ha, ha, ha," he laughed. Sarah laughed too. "How could an old woman like me have a baby?" But sure enough, God did keep his promise to Abraham and Sarah. They had a son at the exact time God had planned all along. This isn't really a story about Abraham and why he was so special. It's a story about God and why he is so special. Faith is trusting God to do what only God can do. We can have faith and trust in God. God keeps his promises.